Welcome to the Arabian Traveler Poetry. This is your host, Mohammed Bader, and today I will be reading you a chapter from my book, The Traveler, called Utopia versus Morbidity. Hope you enjoy. Lost. Don't think me lost. Don't call me from behind the fog. Don't pull me by a thread hanging from the clouds. Don't hold my hands from behind the fog, for I am lost, a vagabond. I sing to the world and the world sings to me. I live my destiny and go my way. Clouds chase me. Clouds chase me and fog envelops me. And behind the fog, an endless, endless road. I walk and walk and walk. I disappear and disappear and do not know where is my final destination. Great hopes. These great hopes and great desires to aspire, to acquire, is an illusion that eats you like fire. Do you still aspire, or is it that you like fire? I see you burn with passion, climbing the highest mountain. Climb, climb, climb. Then take a breath and look up, then look down. Are you high or are you standing still? Standing still, I hear you say. Moving up, yet feeling immobile. Like a patient on a stretcher, asking, when can I move? You say, up, up, up. I want to wake up. You say, move, 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 move. You say, try better, try harder, try something new. Oh my God, I tried so many. I do not know what will be coming next. The merciless wind. The wind carries you without mercy. It folds you. It surrounds you. And it transfers you to a hell you don't know. In spite of that, you enter hell with a torch of hope. Hopes, songs, and musical dreams. You search all means of comfort. Magically, hell transforms to heaven. A heaven made by your hands. You ornament it how you please. Bring maids and mermaids. After a while, you start to admire something called ecstasy. Life becomes like a wheel. Events repeat themselves. And ecstasies enumerate. History repeats itself time after time. Then the soul wanders. What does it want? Ecstasy after ecstasy. No, it's a shock. Renders you numb, spacey, floating in emptiness. When ecstasy vanishes, you feel strange. You feel bitter. You feel anger. Life becomes like water without taste, smell, or color. You try to hold on to anything that gives you hope. The wind comes again, it carries you without mercy, it folds you, it surrounds you, and transfers you to another hill. Congratulations. You are a step ahead. Once again, you create wonders from hell. You build dreams and float in emptiness. After all ecstasies are over, without doubt, you still feel strange. Once again, the wind carries you without mercy. It folds you, surrounds you, and throws you to a hell you do not know. Perfection. Along the way, I'm walking along the way with all my shortcomings, trudging away to come close to you and to my perfection. It is so tedious, my friends, I'm afraid I'm not able to hold on that perfect dream of being perfect. I am not perfect, and I accept it deep in my soul. I accept my humanity. Along the way, I am walking along the way with all my shortcomings. I'm trudging away, trudging to you and to my perfection. A bit closer, perhaps? A bit better, more exact, more sharp, perhaps? Lighter, brighter, shorter, and narrower, perhaps? All the adjectives, perhaps, my friend. I'm trudging heavily to fulfill a dream, my friend. The roses I planted died. The pictures I took came out dark. The paintings I started are not finished. The colors perhaps were dimmer than they should be. It is so tedious, my friend. I'm afraid I'm not able to hold on that perfect dream of being perfect. Finally, I admit it. I am not perfect, and I accept it. Loneliness. An old black horse among thousands of white yearlings, gazing sadly at the sky. An owl singing to it to who, and nobody replies. An abandoned hut in the lonely desert, waiting for a single nightcomer. An old mother waiting for a fighting son to come back home. An eagle grasping a crag ringed with the azure world. A philosopher spending nights deliberating about the secret of existence. A worshiper crouching all night watching the rise of the dawn silently. Loneliness. An artist drawing the moon in a calm summer. After all. After all, you shall depart your soul. Thrown in a dark, narrow hole, you shall sleep alone. Whether you like it or not, you cannot fuss about it. After all, it's all you have. All you own. It's nothing but a dark hole, a chilly, humid tomb. After all, you shall sleep alone. Christmas music. Another Christmas comes by, another place to run by, perhaps more treasures, perhaps more pleasures. Upon a day when every soul cannot run away, you come to my day and make it bright, and make it light, and move me into your fantasy land. Christmas may not have been for you and me. We may never believe in Santa, but what I believe in is that my spirit lifts up when I hear the music of Christmas. Meditation. O Lord, comfort me. O Lord, I abide in Thee. O Lord, comfort me. O Lord, I worship Thee. I appear lost, my Lord, from that lesson You taught me, that left me humble. So counsel me. Counsel me. Without You, Lord, there is no me. Rain. Drip, drip. Rain drops fall upon my lips. Drip, drip. The north wind chills my hips. Swish, swish. Water splashes all over my chin. Hazy daisy, today is cloudy and breezy. Tomorrow will be shiny and rosy. The weatherman has gone amok. He took sunshine and locked it away. So let's pray he'll bring it back on a rainy day. A bird. I'm a simple man with a simple mission. Simplest things make me happy. A bird looking for a feed, singing, dancing, mating and prancing, caught my sight and brought delight to my heart. Flying high and twittering away, she left plenty of joy to color my day. I'm a simple man with a simple mission. Simplest things make me happy. Insomnia, severe insomnia, then insomnia. Where from? Don't know. Scruples of mind, and the mind rebellious. Awake, fumbling in this world, chasing a mirage. What does man think of after he fulfilled his animalistic instincts? After man fulfills the illusion of accomplishment, what does man think of? Homeland? Family? Friends? Humanity? God or a higher power? Or the destruction that accompanies the world? Or of orphans who wander amidst destruction? The tears from a child's eye leave us with one question. Why? Why? Tell me, my friend. What should a man think of? When you come to bed at night, you close your eyes shut, and when the world is asleep, all your senses awake in your body. You wish you were a machine with an off-on button. Turn it off. Turn it off. Or you can stay awake and spend the night with the angels. Forceful passion. This forceful passion, this calamity, serenity and clear vitality. The human animal in us, tamed, demure. Swift to cry, swift to hit, swift to judge, swift to fight. Swift to do anything to fulfill that animalistic passion. This is my life. This is my life. I love it. With its disaster and originality and beauty and elegance, and by the legends I read, and by the rainstorm that drowned it, and by the torturous storms that tore it. This is my life, temporary, borrowed. Life started rough, and perhaps it will end rough. This is my life, and I am not the maker of it. It followed me and befriended me, built me and destroyed me. It's all I have. And who am I? Dust, water, and soul had blown into a fragile flesh. A borrowed life, and I'm not the maker of it. And when my soul departs my body, nothing remains but dust, a dust that will scatter. This is my life. And despite of its harshness, I love it as is, by its purpose and futility, by its frankness, and by all that which is difficult. Whispers. When the sun sets and when the stars light the sky like candles, and when the wind accelerates playing beautiful musical melodies, and when tranquil quietness envelops the whispers, then I sing whisperingly and dance. I gather all my senses, which brings me closer to the Creator. Night Owl 2. Night comes, darkness settles, and extreme cold. Thoughts float in space looking for a lost star, and looking for a moon to light the darkness, and looking for a fire to warm the sad heart. Night comes and all secrets awake. Everybody is asleep except the night owl. Sad and lonely. None befriended her except a dimly lit moon and a few scattered stars, which disappeared behind the heavy fog. The night owl gives her secrets to one of the stars and goes to sleep, and the next day she does the same. She gives the moon and the star her secrets, then goes to sleep. The night. The night is my friend, my lover, my suit that covers my body and covers my shortcomings, a lover that keeps my company, a hound that chases me, a priest that comforts me, a nightmare that awakens me, a brook that quenches my thirst, a mirage that keeps me thirsty, a blessing that follows me, a misfortune that shocks me. The night is my friend and lover. The night brings me closer to the Creator. You have been listening to Utopia versus Morbidity, written, produced, and read to you by Mohammed Bader, aka The Arabian Traveler. If you enjoyed this, please consider supporting me. You can find the support link on my podcast, or contact me via my email, thearabiantraveler@gmail.com. Thank you.